Right, so here we are again for the fourth episode of my Kerbal Space Program career mode playthrough, where today we are going to attempt to break the sound barrier with a manned rocket plane. And unfortunately I already recorded it and the game crashed during recording it, because that is what Kerbal Space Program does. And so I'm just sort of reenacting the first few minutes of the video until the crash, where we accepted the contract from the Career Evolution contract pack, and then built, or actually did not build, but just loaded a pre-built rocket plane, which is this one, except that it did not have this additional boosters. And I built this rocket plane quite a while ago. It is named K1, which is totally not inspired by the Bell X1. So yeah, this basically is what we have done. We have added a little parachute, which we did not need in the end, or a little ejection seat. And that's about the spacecraft that we have used. So let's, I think we can fool the Kerbal construction time mod. And to prevent any further fire corruption, I'm going to stop the video for a brief moment before we head to the run. And here we are, we have successfully fooled the Kerbal construction time mod by pressing this little submenu to select the launch site. So, anyway, spoiler alert, we did not reach the required speed of 343 meters per second. So, because I know it's not going to happen, we can just have a little flight over the Kerbal Space Center. And, so hold on, flaps down, activate SAS. And let's record it from this position, so we get at least some... Oh dear. And Jebediah Kerman had his first crash. So, anyway, let's do that again. Maybe be more careful this time instead of getting some nice pictures. So let's take off. Yeah, the launch phase definitely is dangerous with this little rocket plane. Steps up. And we reached a speed of about 280 meters per second. So it was looking good for most of the time until the drag just increased at transonic speeds. So let's turn around. And fly a few circles. So I'm just filming this now to show off this little rocket plane. Actually, I really like it. And we could do a little aerobatic display, sort of. Oh, this is not really aerobatics now, but never mind. Down. I did put the flaps down later. Not a very good landing.
Stay away
breaking the anyway, as I said, even if we were flying level in order to reach maximum speed, what I did before, this little rocket plane would not reach Mach 1 on itself, so let's revert to the space plane hangar. And what I then did was remove this little parachute module and add two boosters under the wing of this little deltas. The shrimp boosters. And in order to build this little rocket plane with level 1 facilities, I actually had to move some more stuff in the tech tree. So anyway, let's see you after the crash, where I'm also launching from the desert airfield, because the desert airfield is at a greater altitude where the air is thinner, so the drag will be lower and the rocket engines actually have more performance. So let's see you after the crash. So 14 minutes later, both in-game, because the vessel was built, and in real life, because the game crashed, we are here again. And yeah, we have to press select launch site and the desert airfield and launch. Crew still is Jebediah Kerman, so everything is looking good now. And yeah, try again. Okay, it is daytime, so you can estimate how far away we are from the Kerbal Space Center. Staging is good. Deploy the flaps. Off we go. Hope it will function this time to reach 343 meters per second. Rotate. Retract the flaps to reduce drag, and at first we will fly a little bit up, let's say to 1000 meters. And once we have reached 1000 meters, we can level out and activate next engine. We have to jettison the small motor absolutely on time. Oh, 90 meters per second. 20 seconds to go. And just cut off 300 meters per second. And acceleration is reduced, so it's getting slower. Ah, we have failed again. Shit. So let's glide back and come up with a better idea. A little bit of time warp, because the glide back otherwise would take quite a moment. But maybe we will stick with no time warp in order to prevent crashes. I think we could also already build the K-15. rocket plane that I designed before. You can also find that one in the Steam Workshop. And the K-15 definitely, absolutely reaches Mach 1. But with the K-15 we have the problem that it flies such a long distance that you cannot return to your takeoff runway. But on the other hand, it is not having the range to, like, let's say, fly from here to the Kerbal Space Center, or from here to Baikal Banur, and you would have to ditch it somewhere, which I also do not like to do. This time we are landing more properly than on the last flight. I think what we will do is just add more boosters, like one of the most Kerbal things you can do. And we can also collect an EVA report. Board again and recover to SPH. So this time the recovery takes 31 minutes. So I think the time a vessel needs to recover definitely depends on the distance at which it is from the Kerbal Space Center. Research 5 ribbon, because Jebediah Kerman already has research 250 signs. Remove that alarm. And warp to complete. So let's edit it again and fuel up the motor, and this time we will not add 2 but 4 or maybe perhaps even 6. Might solid rocket motors. We are at 19 parts and have 11 to go. Yep, it's looking good. To move that one a little bit further out. That one a little bit back like this. Let's see, it still is. Yeah, it's looking good. So let's make it more aerodynamic. Ah, we have exceeded the part count. Search for some. There's literally nothing we can remove, so we have to remove. Let's make it the outermost engine. Move that one down. And now it takes 5 days to build it. Save the edits. Ah, yeah, the last time it was so fast because we have removed things anyway. Delete the alarm. And warp 5 days ahead. Select launch site and again the desert airfield. Jebediah Kerman, everything looking good, and launch. So the flaps are already down. Activate SAS. And we already have reached 1000 meters because that will be very fast for the helicopter engine. Himmelmann turn. Perhaps we could even fly to the old desert temple that is somewhere over there, but then the recovery is going to be expensive. Where we get the full refund for our little airplane if we landed at the desert runway. But we can do a low pass. Flying low and fast. And there it is, the Mach 1 ribbon. I think he did not get it before, I'm not sure. We have to take care not to pull too hard, because if the pilot passes out at a low level over ground, definitely is not good and most likely not going to end well. I don't know what causes this weird sound. And we can try to cockpit view. What you heard there is the... No, we haven't lost anything. What you heard there is the ship effects. Flaps down. Gear down. What you heard or also can hear here is the ship effects mod that adds this this little tracking noises and some other noises. I was just wondering why the nose is not coming up. But anyway, we have landed almost without breaking anything. And any landing that you can walk away from is a good landing. So let's recover. Do the normal recovery, because we won't need this airplane anymore. Not even for now. I don't think we will ever need it anymore. pseudoscience, 16,000 funds, and the Mach 1 ribbon. And as you can see, we have gotten quite a lot of funds for completing this contract. And I think this can conclude the Mach 1 episode, and we will see again in the next episode where we are going to build the first ever satellite. And again, if you have liked the video, I appreciate a like and a subscription to this channel, and you can also check out my main channel. And I hope to see you again in the next episode.